Hello, here we are going to discuss the Hindu newspaper analysis of this 10th of November. So this is the front page. In this front page, the one news is the constitutional bench to hear plea on bid to sway Supreme Court judge. So it is regarding the corruption in the High Court judge. So here SIT under ex-CJI sought to probe attempt to influence medical college case ruling. So here it don't go too much in detail. Here only thing is, regarding the example for this corruption that is prevailing in the higher judiciary also. For that only it matters, otherwise there is no requirement to go in detail in this news. Next is this records turnout 74% this in Himachal Pradesh elections. Again, it is good for democracy. So again, it is, you can use as an example. Student facing rape at knife point tells friends, okay, avoid this. Second thoughts on KPME Act amendments, avoid this. Nationwide IT versus avoid this. Or an event for, this is also GST Council tighten norms. This also news you can avoid. Next is this page. That is after suspending. Again, this page is not as important, so we can directly move to this nation page. In this nation page, blame game over pollution. That is important news is, okay. So blame game over this pollutions. So this figure, this is showing that this pollution is not only confined to Delhi, but all this northern belt, that is Lahore, New Delhi, Lucknow, Patna, all these are having actually aerosol optical depth map that is given by NASA. So here we need to know that it is not about. Another important thing we need to know about this SAFAR. SAFAR is, this is system of air quality and weather forecasting and research index. Ye kya hai that, and which agency actually issue this, Union Earth Science. So that also we need to know about this. Another, this 20% rise in respiratory distress cases, follow NGT guidelines, say commissioner, no need to panic, and High Court issues directions to improve air quality. So this news is important. Okay, so this news is important. Here is another is this Rayan teen confessed in front of father. So CBI, so here actually we need to know what is the problem in our police system is this, because earlier police has told that it is the driver that has actually murdered the child, but now CBI has inquired and it found out that it was the senior, that is class 11th student, has actually murdered this teen Pradyumna Kumar. So we need to know what is the problem is happening in our parenting system. So this is the good example for in our case study, especially for ethics paper. What is the problem since, and what is the role of this school society and this family in the upbringing of the children. So that another is, there is a requirement of police reform because there must be in some problem or this political involvement, because of that this happens. That also we need to know. So, and this is also not that CBI is always right, because we know that recently this ROC murder case also CBI was inquiring that case, and CBI has messed up that complete case. Here in this case police has messed up this case. So we need to that the entire investigation agencies and police reforms are required. Another important, this Olive Ridley keeps date with Odisha. So what is this Olive Ridley is? It is important for your environment section. So Olive Ridley, so whether they comes under which list of IUCN, okay, like whether they comes in endangered list or critically endangered list, that we need to know. And Olive Ridley is the endangered turtle. So this comes under endangered. So because here we can see that Olive Ridley, every time they come in this Odisha coast and they lay their eggs and then again they return back. So we need to know about this coastal, which are the rivers are there, where they do this all, okay, egg laying. So we need to know about these things. Next come is, again, after that you need to know about editorial page. Here an editorial page is, under pressure, why police investigators should not jump to conclusions influenced by police outrage. That we need to cover. Night of the long knives and RIA, definitely we can avoid this. This is not important for our UPSC purpose. Another, Zimbabwean stacks, here only for geographical purpose you need to go through the map and need to see where Zimbabwe is located in African continent, and then which of the other countries that is sharing boundary with Zimbabwe. Other things you need to know about this, whatever the important rivers of the Zimbabwe and mountain range of the Zimbabwe and the lakes that are found in Zimbabwe, that we need to know. Another important things we need to know, why Zimbabwe, actually the currency issues are happening because of high inflation is happening, that we call hyperinflation. So what were the reasons of this hyperinflation in Zimbabwe? Rest of the things you can avoid. For a wider cover, India needs to design its tree-based program better to meet climate goals, because we have seen more often, okay, there is the thing is that, for example, most of the states, they are actually making a Guinness World Records in the sense, for example, this Guinness World Records of recently this Madhya Pradesh planted 60 million trees in 12 hours to enter the record books. And here overtaking Uttar Pradesh record of planting 49.3 million trees in a day in 2016. So what is the benefit will happen by this planting, that we need to know, because carbon sequestrations will help, whether so somehow they are going to help the in the livelihood of the communities, those who are living nearby, and whatever the other things we can actually improve in this tree plantation. So that is the important things. Now next is this. Especially this capitalization, there are three issues are there: will bank recapitalize and fix NPAs. So here, yes, okay, the three views are there: yes, no, and complicated. So we need to cover all the threes, but whatever the things has been covered, okay, in these three articles already we have covered in earlier articles. Now it takes a village, how to fix accountability in a school system. This is also another important article. Okay, so it takes a village is also one of the book written by Hillary Clinton. We need to know that things. Okay, so how to fix accountability in a school. So this how we can cover this, how to fix accountability in a school system. Correct. So here is, for some time now accountability has become the buzzword in school education. Everyone seems to have suggestions about the fixing education by holding teachers accountable for student test scores. Means whenever students are not giving good score in their test, then we consider that education system is not good. So here in this article, author is trying to say that test scores should not become the benchmark for any educational system. Correct. And we need not to actually always put blame over the teachers, because it is not only the teacher, but other stakeholders are also there, and that blame need to put over other stakeholders. So here is UNESCO's new global education monitoring report. Here in this report, the role of accountability in global education system to achieve the vision of this United Nations Sustainable Development Goal 4. Sustainable Development Goal, there are 17 Sustainable Development Goal. In that 17 Development Goal, fourth goal is to ensure inclusive and quality education for all and to promote lifelong learning. Means by 2030, we need to ensure that every single student need to be educated. The report points out that providing universal quality education depends not on the performance of the teacher alone. See, that reports this as global education monitoring report says that providing universal quality education not depends on the performance of teacher alone, but is the shared responsibility of several stakeholders. So who are the several stakeholders? Here is government, schools, teachers, parents, media, civil society, international organizations, and private sector. It does need to take an entire village. So using poor test score to punish teacher is a bad idea for many reasons, including the risk that it might result in teachers simply teaching to the test. So what will happen, teachers is going to teach only those things which are going to be asked in the test paper, so that students can score much. So what will happen, ultimate outcome will be there, this ki the outcome of education will be very 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 narrow outcome. Correct. So they will not be having a comprehensive learning of their life, whatever other things are required for in well-educated person. So teaching to the test is never a good way forward for any education system. Examining scores by themselves are an inadequate way of assessing the complex process of teaching and learning. So not only does an exclusive focus on test scores have the risk of leaving weaker students behind, because what will happen if we are focusing only on the test scores, what will happen, those students which are weaker, they will be left behind, and it also leaves academically better performing students with a narrow understanding of what education is all about. So those who are the toppers, they will be having only narrow understanding of what education. Even We should know that the founder of Alibaba, okay, Jack Ma of China, he said once that he actually asked his children that don't try to top in the school, because if you started trying top in the school, then what will happen? Your focus will be only on those books which are actually taught in the schools. Only thing you need to do ki only to clear the exam, pass the exam. Because if you are only passing the exam, then definitely you are also giving your time in other activities. And because of that, the 360 degree development of a student will take place. That is always a better choice, correct? Now, don't blame teachers here. Why? Because as for teachers' absence, very often reasons for this are behind teachers' own control. Because it is not that teachers are absent because of their personal reasons. Because we have seen in India, teachers are involved in other non-academic activities also. For example, Pulse Polio Mission, Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan Mission, elections are there, elections of say, union government elections at the state legislature assembly, elections of the local panchayat. Means in most of this unacademic, non-academic activity, teachers are involved. Even this midday meal scheme, again teachers are involved here, and because of that and other non-academic activities of the school itself, they are actually not able to present themselves in the school. Even though Azim Premji Foundation, this Azim Premji Foundation has done one survey, and he has found that in the survey, this foundation has found that while overall percentage of teachers not in school was 18.5%. Overall percentage of teachers not in the school means total 18.5% teachers were not found in the school. Of these, either they were out of school on other official duty or in bona fide leave. Actual teacher absentee because of teacher's fault is only 2.5%. Means teachers were actually absent because of his own personal reasons, own personal fault, only 2.5. Major teachers were absent because of either they were out on for school work or they were out for non-other academic activities or therefore campaigning for the government programs. So if the larger problem is of teacher shortages, perhaps it is time to talk about accountability with a constructive focus on the role of each stakeholders in the education system. So thing is this, how can we better fund and resource school and colleges? That question we need to answer. If we want to develop a good education system, so first these three, four questions need answers. Means how can we better fund and resource schools and colleges? How can we better train and support our teachers? How we can help communities to ensure that every child is in school? And how we can support parents, so many of whom never went to school themselves, in helping their children learn? Okay, we have seen the Hindi medium movie here. We have seen that even parents are not, means they were not literate, then many of the good schools, especially private schools, they avoid to actually give admissions to their children. This is another problem we need to solve. So accountability mechanisms should be developed for education system that are supportive. Accountability mechanisms should be developed for education system that are supportive, constructive, and focus as much as on fundamental issues of accessibility, equity, and inclusion as on quality. So this article is important especially for your essay paper, because right now from last 2-3 years, UPSC is continuously asking one essay on one sector of education. That is why this is important. This also important for paper 3, where education is one of the important topic of the syllabus. And this also can be used in our ethics paper in case it is how to ensure a better education system in our society. Because we have seen just now that in Rayan school, the murder of teen happens, done by his senior fellow, that is 11th standard student. So what is the problem in that educational system is we need to improve here. Now next thing is this. This is all about this. Sustainable development goals are, we do not try to remember all the 17, but we need to know what are the, like goal number 1, no poverty, goal number 2, no hunger, goal number 3, good health, goal number 4, quality education, 5th is gender equality, 6th is clean water and sanitation, 7th is renewable energy, 8th is good jobs and economic growth, 9th is innovations and infrastructure, 10th is reduced inequalities, 11th is sustainable cities and communities, 12th is responsible consumptions, 13th is climate action, 14th is life below water. See, this is also very good, life below water, that is marine life. Fifth is life on land, and sixth is peace and justice, and 17th partnership for the gold. These are the 17th sustainable development goal. And this fourth quality education, that is fourth goal, quality education, ensure inclusive and equitable quality education and promote lifelong learning opportunities for all. Here actually global literacy rate is 91%, but 57 million children remain out of school. What is the condition of India? In India actually 73% adults are literate. 73% adults are literate, and the definition of literate is this: whosoever is above the age of 7 years can read and write in any language is considered as literate. So very crude definition is of literate. And here in rural area only 58% are literate, and 54% of people with disabilities are literate, and 34% children with special needs are out of school. This is a very big actually crisis, that 34% children with special needs are out of school. And then 100% enrollments of girls in primary education, but only 22.7% in higher education. So here, this is gender inequality in education is this. So we can quote this fact, 100% enrollment of girls in primary education, but only 22.7% in higher education. 360 million largest youth population in the world that India is having, and 23% total enrollment in higher education. Means if 100 youths are there, only 23 youths are going for higher education. 92% female and 94% male youth are illiterate in India right now. That is the good thing. Now, this article actually, it belongs to especially this Indian Express, because Indian Express, one article came, this one article, okay, what we can learn from this Mexico City, this series of steps, this article was important. What Delhi has not learned, that lessons from Mexico City, series of steps needed to signal that life cannot go as usual when air too toxic. So this is this, what Delhi has not learned. So thing is this, what actually Mexico City has done, because in 1992, Mexico City, there was a lot of air pollution was there. And we can also know the topography of Mexico City. Mexico City topography is in the valley. Because since it actually lies in the valley, because of that reasons, it is not, it means easy for the air, polluted air to escape from the Mexico. That is the reason is in 1992, the air pollution level in Mexico was very high. So what steps they have taken? For example, compulsory use of catalytic converters in every car, okay, compulsory catalytic converters in every car so that thus vehicle emissions can be reduced. Second is mandatory verification of car emissions every 6 months. In our country, the PUC certificate that vehicle used to take, most of the time there is corruption is involved. A serious improvement of public transportation is required, for examples, including the expansions of metro lines, because metro are the most green transport system. Then a bus rapid transit system, example in Surat and Ahmedabad has actually adopted this system by the name of metro bus. A bike sharing program also, for example, like Ola Share, okay, Uber Share, same way bike sharing programs also, among other. These were the steps taken by the Mexico to reduce the air pollution. A road space rationing strategy. Road space rationing strategy in the sense is some of the road, part of the road need to be given to the bicycle rider only. Because the problem is this right now in Indian cities is this, especially Delhi, Bangalore and Hyderabad, in these cities. Even though you want to go okay by bicycle, but you are going to avoid, because first important thing is there is no dedicated path is given to bicycle. So that thing is that accidental hazard cannot possible. That is the reason is a road space rationing strategy is required. If this much of road is given to the bicycle, this much road is given to the public transportation system, and this much road is given to the private vehicles. So private vehicles, road need to be given very less. A two-phase program for atmospheric environmental contingency was also created in case of serious spikes in the level of pollutants. So here is phase one is, so this program was actually also started in this Mexico City, program for atmospheric environmental contingency. This program is all about that things, ki suppose if any emergency happens, for example in Delhi right now is facing emergency. So in these emergency situations, what are the steps can be taken, okay, to avoid the hazardness due to the air pollution. So phase one is declared when the levels of ozone reach an equivalent of 0.166 parts per million, 1 hour average, or when levels of PM10 reach 221. Okay, now for example, in Delhi right now, PM 10 average is 999. Means whatever the machine is there to measure this PM 10 there, they are not equipped to show the data in 4 digits actually. That is the reason is they reached 999, means they are not equipped to show the data in 4 digits, for example 1000 or 1200 in such a way, because they never thought that air pollution will reach to this level. Okay, that is the another problem. With phase 1, authorities set in motion action to protect the health of citizens in 4 different categories. For example, recommendations will be given transportation, services and industries. So schools and government institutions in phase 1, schools and government institutions are expected to cease all outdoor activities. For example, in Delhi right now, we have closed schools there. So schools and government institutions are expected to cease all outdoor activities. Civic and recreational, okay, and citizens are advised that exercising outdoor represents a health hazard, and healthcare professionals are on alert to receive vulnerable patients and are responsible for spreading informations. In phase 1, several industries were forced to reduce their operations to a certain level. All these measures and many others are suspended until pollution levels descend to the prescribed level, even if it takes some days or even some weeks. So curbing air pollution is a serious problem that demands long-term multi-pronged strategy, correct? And one more thing we can do to procure only zero emission buses, that Delhi need to do. That Delhi has done. Delhi have converted diesel and petrol vehicles into a CNG vehicles. So we require zero emission buses. So that is the importance of this, how Delhi also can adopt some measures to reduce this air pollution. Next is economic gravity, where India is ahead of this China. Here actually author is Kaushik Basu, our economy earlier economic advisor. Here he is trying to say what was the India's early investment. India's early investment in secularism, cultural openness, freedom of speech, which made the early years difficult for economic growth, is now in position to pay off. Means India has invested more actually time on secularism, cultural openness, freedom of speech. But China has actually invested more on economic investment, economic growth and development, okay? And because of that, China actually has much ahead. Because in 1960s, China is India's per capita income was almost same. China's and India's GDP was almost same. But now actually China's GDP is actually many factors ahead from this India. Per capita income is also ahead compared to India. But India has invested earlier in secularism and cultural openness. So why actually this, whatever the India has invested earlier, is going to be benefit India? So here is China's economic performance from 1969, a year in which its growth rate was an unbelievable 16.9%. During 1969, India's growth rate was Hindu growth rate that we called 4.5%. That means what? Whatever the economic growth was, it was equal to the population growth of India. And more relentlessly from 1978 has been outstanding. One reason for the success is the coercive power that we already know. One reason for this in China's growth is its coercive power of its leaders, because they will be having no problem in implementation of any reform like in India. This enabled China to push through tough reforms. But India's this cacophonous democracy placed many more restraints on the leaders and often made it impossible for them to make essential reform. For example, earlier BJP government has tried to put reform, especially Land Acquisition Act, but they were unable to pass this reform because of this democratic nature of our polity. Conversely, India's early investment in secularism, cultural openness, freedom of speech, which did make the early years difficult for economic growth, is now in a position to pay off. And same thing in USA. In USA also, economic growth or development, what actually happens in USA? In USA, political rights were given later, economic rights were given earlier. Correct. In USA also, when USA became the first democratic country with this constitution, in USA first actually economic rights were given, right to private property, all these were given to the citizens. But political rights were given much later. But India, what happens after independence, soon 1947, political rights and economic rights both were given at the same time. And because of that, all peoples were having political rights, especially this system of adult suffrage, because there will be no discriminations in the case of vote. They actually started using this actually voting power to influence India's economic reform. That is why it becomes very difficult for India to put reform. And another important, politicians also started means implementing only those reforms which are beneficial for them in the next future elections. So a disproportionate amount of its GDP is produced by in China, especially in China case, a disproportionate amount of its GDP, that is China's GDP, is produced by state-owned sectors, and the Communist Party has representatives on the board of private companies. It is a top-down system. Why it is a top-down system? Because most of the GDP that is China is having, it is produced by state-owned companies, and whatever the private companies are there, in these private companies, the board of directors, all this, the Communist Party's representation is there. That failed in most countries but seems to have succeeded in China. So what China's experience shows is that coercive system run by intelligent reason can yield dividends. That means it is not always correct that always democratic country is going to succeed in any economic growth. China has shown to the world that with a coercive system run by intelligent leaders can yield dividends. So under like Deng Xiaoping, this was the person who actually opened the China's economy in 1978. So important name, Deng Xiaoping leadership. Critical space was created for market forces in 1978. At the same time, a clever interventionist policy was devised for exchange rates, which promoted exports. Correct. Because how actually China has promoted exports? Clever interventionist policy. This clever interventionist policy in the sense China used to undervalue its currency, because when China is going to undervalue its currency, definitely the cost of its product is going to be much cheaper in the international market compared to its competitor. And since the cost of its product becomes cheaper, because of that exports will grow very high, and because of this high exports growth, China's trade surplus is there. Correct. So, and in this, Xi Jinping, that is current president of China, we see an extraordinary capacity for management and control as well as for global engagement. Because we can see now, because there in USA, Donald Trump's continuously this hawkish policies, even without directionless policies, because of all that, global leaders have lost trust, okay, in Donald Trump's. And this Xi Jinping, okay, he is growing continuously. Because of that, now China is most probably going to become equal to the USA. Now, what about the concerns about China? Means whatever the China is having some concern, because a coercive top-down system after a while acquires its own rise in the ether, and when that happens, the interest of those at the top run contrary to the interest of the nation. Means after some time, what will happen? China's the top-down system. Whosoever, those who are in the top of this system, their interest will run to the contrary to the common person at the ground. This coercive structure is then used to preserve political power rather than to promote development. So this, after some time, they will try to, because whenever those who are living in the ground level, they try to actually bring reforms, or they will try to protest against the system, then ultimately this coercive structure will try to preserve political power instead of to promote development. So the key lesson is a top-down coercive system may work for a while but tends to backfire in the long run. Okay. So, but again, we do not know how much this sentence is correct, means correct for the China, because this sentence has been quoted by earlier authors also, okay, China will going to decline by this date, China is going to decline, growth decline will this date, China will collapse, all these things, actually this type of articles are coming from the last 30 years, but China is still stays strong, and its economic growth and economic development is still means moving at the very fast pace. So in societies like China and India, a special problem pertains to the control of corruption. So corruption is not the problem only with society like China and India, that corruption is prevailed in most of the societies. Because corruption is so pervasive, leaders, even if they are genuinely keen on controlling it, face a choice of who they will go after, in friends or oppositions. Correct? For example, currently in India also, like BJP, they are going against the corruption done by the opposition parties, but whenever there is an issue comes of corruption done by their own party leaders, okay, there is complete silence is there. So that has becomes the problem for those leader, genuine leader who want to get rid of corruptions, but it becomes difficult for them to choose whether to go after the opposition or whether to go after the friends who are doing the corruptions. Soon the anti-corruption drive becomes an instrument for silencing the dissent. Okay, again, this is this anti-corruption drive becomes an instrument of silencing dissent. Okay, so whenever who is going against you, these anti-corruption drives, say what we can do, we can shut the mouth of those who are opposing you. Both India and China face this risk, but it is bigger for China because of the absence of free media. Now, China's top-down system is so all-embracing. Okay, this China's top-down system is so all-embracing that it may be impossible to dismantle, because those who are involved in the top-down system, they will try to preserve that political order, and therein lies India's strength. Thanks to the nation's early commitment to democracy, openness and free media, it is now in position to reap the benefits. So India's high growth from 2005 has many drivers, but those early social and political investments are prominently among them. But thing is that we do not know how much means truth is in this statement, because it only authors know about this, because author has not given any sustainable facts that is going to support this statement, correct? So it could be a political statement also. Now next is, its systems with vents open for continuous descent may make growth a little slower. Correct? For that very reason, Seorer. So India's big risk is that rise of right-wing religious vigilantism in recent years. Recent years, we like cow vigilantisms, okay, love jihad vigilantisms, all these. So author is saying that it can give a big risk to India's growth. These acts are led by people with a deep sense of inferiority about their own nation, and so they like to shout from rooftops about their greatness 5 million ago. That means this author is saying that currently those right-wingers or fundamentalists, they're trying to bring their old system that exists 5 million years ago. Because why actually they want ancient system? Because they were feeling inferior. They actually having this feeling of inferiority about their present system. But this is wrong actually. The silencing of dissent and free media, the use of threats and even actual violence that has emerged from this group is a genuine risk for India. So definitely it is a correct statement, because if there is silencing of dissent and free media will happen, then private investment will going to suffer in India. That is why this is the correct statement. So this was actually came in our this Indian Express article. So this was the only important thing is, after that we do not require. So next thing is this here, demonetizations are arbitrary, constituents bench to hear plea. This we can avoid this article. Traders, exporters keep their fingers crossed, GST council to tighten. Okay, for this we can learn something tomorrow about this program. Interlocutors reaches Jammu, again we can avoid this. India China borders talks next month, again it is not as important. Rural youth need support, okay, something we can read about here. And then government want to duck tough questions before poll, again we can avoid this news. Okay, so this is all about today's newspaper analysis. Okay, so now the thing is, this is the complete of today's 10th November news analysis. Okay, so please like this video and comment in the section if whatever you want any improvement. Okay, thank you for this.